Then the moon rose like a wonderful silver shield, and the stars began to shine, and a sound of music came from the palace. The prince and princess were leading the dance. They danced so beautifully that the tall white lilies peeped in at the window and watched them, and the great red poppies nodded their heads and beat time. Then 10 o'clock struck, and then 11, and then 12. And at the last stroke of midnight, every one of them came out on the terrace, and the king sent for the royal pyrotechnist.
"Let the fireworks begin," said the king,
and the royal pyrotechnist made a low bow and marched down to the end of the garden. He had 6 attendants with him, each of whom carried a lighted torch at the end of a long pole. It was certainly a magnificent display. Whiz, whiz, went the Catherine wheel as she spun round and round. Boom, boom, went the Roman candle. Then the squibs danced all over the place, and the Bengal lights made everything look scarlet. Goodbye, cried the fire balloon as she soared away, dropping tiny blue sparks. Bang, bang, answered the crackers, who were enjoying themselves immensely. Everyone was a great success except the remarkable Rocket. He was so damp with crying that he could not go off at all. The best thing in him was the gunpowder, and that was so wet with tears that it was of no use. All his poor relations, to whom he would never speak, except with a sneer, shot up into the sky like wonderful golden flowers with blossoms of fire. "Huzzah! Huzzah!" cried the court, and the little princess laughed with pleasure.